home for the broken. That's what the Los Angeles County Poor Farm was for its inhabitants, providing solace and hope to the handicapped, homeless, mentally ill, and elderly. Established in 1888 in Downey, California, the Poor Farm operated as a form of social welfare for able-bodied residents who were unable to afford room, board, and medical care, giving them the alternative of working on the self-sufficient farm, tending to livestock, and cultivating crops. The Poor Farm's successful agricultural focus encouraged LA County to transform the campus into a county medical facility, seeing as how patients would not only have a steady source of food available to them, but would also make more resources available to the ill. Individuals transferred here from the state mental hospitals and the Los Angeles County Hospital, making the county farm a type of catch-all institution. By the late 1890s, overcrowding became an issue, prompting the expansion that included the following structures: an administrative building, an auditorium, the women's psychiatric ward, the men's psychiatric ward, a bathhouse and laundry building, a dairy barn, a water tower, general health wards, infirmary wards, Superintendent William Ruddy Harriman's home, and many other historic sites. With the end of the First World War came the birth of the Spanish flu, reaching the farm in 1918. Surprisingly, only one patient died, symbolizing the strong resilience of the institution and reinforcing their motto to its full potential: service with a heart. This resilience maintained itself to be true throughout the 1920s to the 1930s, with the expansion of the infirmary wards following the mother of all pandemics. About 4,000 souls received top care at the farm's medical department, which received several thousand dollars worth of new equipment. The Poor Farm faced tribulations during the Great Depression, with new patients from the white-collar section of society and a tighter budget to accommodate them all. Superintendent Harriman realized that the County Poor Farm's name was no longer accurate to the facility's mission and petitioned to change it to its present-day name, Rancho Los Amigos, Spanish for Rancho the Friends. The family feeling for the facility and the nation itself was especially prevalent during World War II, where stable patients and employees alike found work in local airplane factories and even enlisted to defend their home. Those who stayed rationed food as best as they could, and others oversaw the plot of land leased by the U.S. Army, known as Camp Morrow, where patients and employees were briefed on what to do if an invasion occurred. After the war, Rancho became a long-term care facility for war victims and simultaneously managed victims of the polio epidemic, filling up wards with iron lungs in the 1950s. The discovery of the Salk polio vaccine in 1955 placed hundreds of these respirators away in storage, paving the way for recuperation and the facility's mission to this day, rehabilitation.
You know, I love that place because it's kind of a forgotten, I guess you could say, forgotten historical piece of the area. For me, it's kind of a special spot because it's never been changed. It'd be better to save that history over there and put, you know, possibly repurpose those buildings. There's a lot of good plans that have, been around for different areas and have gone through the same kind of transformations. One of them down in San Diego called Liberty Station, which is a really good model that they could follow, which basically takes those old historic buildings and they turn them into restaurants, and they turn them into places where you could possibly live and different things like that. It just makes it kind of a destination instead of just an everyday place that what it'll most likely become if they tear everything down.
Liberty Station was the Naval Training Center in San Diego, functioning during World War II. It has now been repurposed, serving as a portal to the past.
having a resource like that in town so close to the schools would be a great place to, you know, maybe take kids on field trips, especially if they restore those buildings.
The 70-acre property marked the beginning of the present world-renowned medical facility. But on June 23, 2020, the Los Angeles Board of Supervisors voted for the southern campus, in which so many individuals were cared for, to be destroyed. This demolition will result in 60 historical buildings being wiped away from Downey forever, erasing the hard work and tender love both patients and workers had for the facility.